What we've seen and done in Wao is very similar to the situation we are facing all over South Sudan this last year. People being affected by the conflict, people moving, being displaced, and MSF running after the people to try to provide healthcare. MSF went back to Wao last April for an expo, because it used to be a quiet area in the country, but the tension was raising and we were expecting things to get worse, and so we decided to go and have a look on the ground to have a better understanding of the situation in Wao town. When we first went south and west of Wao, the people were hiding in the bush. We didn't see anyone, and we observed looted and destroyed health facilities. So we started doing mobile clinics in this area, especially in Bagari County, to offer health services, because we knew the population was around, even if we didn't see them at the beginning, and to build trust with the people. Maybe 2 weeks after the clash, we started setting up an hospital, a pediatric hospital, temporary health facility, near the new protection of civilian site. You had a lot of people moving again to Bagari, but after a month, the access was blocked. MSF could cross, but with a lot of difficulties, all the other NGOs and UN agencies. All the others stopped moving to Bagari. MSF was able to move because we were moving before. We were known by the authorities and by the people giving access. We already built a bit of trust and they knew what we were doing, but it was nothing regular. It was long negotiation at the checkpoint every single day. Sometimes it was very tough. When access was completely blocked, it was a lot of frustration, of course, for everyone. But we kept trying almost every day, sometimes taking risk because the situation was tense. And we kept trying at different level on the ground with the people denying access, with the authorities, with the other organization. The longest was 5 weeks. That we couldn't go to Bagari without being able to cross and supply and provide healthcare to the population on the other side. Finally, we were able to get through after 5 weeks because we had guarantees and the right documents, but also I think it was building some kind of trust and making people who were denying access aware of who is MSF, what is MSF doing, why we want to cross. That was, I think, the key.